Do you ever wonder which nation you should go on first, or which nation you should go after playing this or this nation that you liked? Well, this video is made for you, because today we are gonna do a tech tree breakdown. What do I mean by that? I'm gonna take every nation and tell you the pros and cons of each of them without talking about some specificities. So really, it's gonna be an overall view, so don't mind me if there are some mistakes talking about some nations, because every nation has some specific tanks that will not fit the nation playstyle. The Russian tech tree doesn't need a lot of skill to be played correctly. What does it mean? It means that this is the perfect starter nation for every new player in the game. If you want to try TDs, go for a Russian TD. If you want to try heavies for the first time, go for the heavies on the Russian tech tree. Really, it's the best nation to start with, because it will allow you to do mistakes without being punished for them. Now, if we take a look at the British tech tree, you need to know three things. The first one is that most of these tanks will have great reloads. Most of the time, the British tanks are the one reloading faster than any other tanks in the game. Exception for the AV1A3, which has a special gun, but I'm not here to talk about this. Furthermore, you also need to know that these tanks have a special, and by special I mean deadly, premium shell, which is the hash, which will allow you to do bigger damage with a bigger penetration than the regular HE. That's important to know. And also, the third fact is that it requires some skill. You need to have some knowledge about the game. Really, I think it's only for experienced player, except if you go for the AV1A3. Even the whole branch is gonna be tough for you, but the AV1A3 is a brain dead tank, because you only need to camp to put your shots. So yeah, that's all I had to say. Let's talk about another nation. The Chinese tank, what do you need to know? Basically, it's the Russian copy-paste with less gun depression, which means that these tanks are not really skilled tanks, but you need to know one thing, the maps. If you don't have knowledge about the maps, where to go to fight with your bad gun depression, you clearly don't want to go for them. So I would say go for the Russian tech tree first, and after go for the Chinese one if you are not sure about your skill, because playing the Russian tanks will allow you to know which position on maps allow you to do damage with a bad gun depression. Now, concerning the Japan tech tree, it's really easy. It's the opposite of the Chinese tanks. For this one, you will really need a lot of skill. It's really high skilled level tanks, because you have a great gun depression, but you don't have armor, and you don't have the best gun ever, so you need to know where to shoot, weak spots, etc. So definitely, that's something I would definitely recommend to high skilled players only. Now, let's take a look at the American tech tree. So what do you need to know? Two main things. The first one is that it's the nation with the best gun depression in the game. And the second fact is that they have strongly armored turret. So basically, I would definitely tell to noobs to go on this tech tree, even if you should go first for the Russian tech tree, because it will allow you to make more mistakes than the Russian ones. But that's definitely a great starter nation. The third nation you must go on, Germany. Why? Because it has a lot of really armored tanks. The problem here is that most of them are slow, except for the mediums, of course, but they are really strongly armored. But it's the armor is really flat, which means you need to know how to angle your tanks to be able to do great in them. So you need to go there when you know how to angle tanks. That's the only thing that matters when you want to play a German tank. Angle it. And let's finish with the French tanks. You need to know two things. The first one is that most of them have clips, which means you will have a long reload but be able to put three shots in a row. That's for the heavy and medium. But concerning the TD, it's a really great one. Even if you have a weak side armor, you definitely need to be careful about this, on how to angle it. And the second fact is that French tanks have a great mobility but not too much armor. So the French tanks, I would say, is for expert players. You really need to know how to deal with lightly armored tanks to be able to play them correctly. So go for them only when you know how to play the tank and how to play really, really well. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope it's gonna help some newbies to know better on which nation they should go for. Thank you all for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. Don't forget, you're not here to be better, but to be the best. Pantoufleee, over.